Hi, this is Tutor P, and this is Lesson 26. Today we're going to look at the differences between herd, pack, flock, and school. Probably the first thing to note here is to realize there are many, many, many names of animal groups. As I looked into it, I didn't realize there were so many. There's probably more than 100. But I'm covering these four because these are the four that we come across probably the most often. Sometimes, again, students, when they hear animal groups, they'll say, well, what's the difference between this animal group and what's the difference between that animal group? So I'm giving you some information so you can pretty much try to figure out at least these four groups of what animals might fit into these categories. So, all right, let's take a look. Let's take a look at the first one here. Herd, a large group of animals that live, feed, and travel around together. Okay, that's good to start with. Also, we could note this, there's a second meaning we have to it too. Also, a group of animals that are herded by humans. Yeah, especially like on a farm or livestock, especially cattle, or any animals in the cow family, you know, buffalo, cows, bulls. But it even includes sheep, horse, you know, on a farm where they, remember, to herd means that they gather them together in a group. So that are herded, especially livestock. So animals that would fall into the livestock category, a lot of them we might use the word herd for. And then here's some other hints that might help you. Again, this is not 100%. We say here we tend to use the term. So tend to, not 100%, but probably, if the animal falls in this category, it might be using the term herd. So we tend to use the term herd with animals that are physically large, yeah, especially like really large animals, are mammals, and often graze. Well, graze also kind of goes back to livestock, because we usually only graze, most livestock graze, you know, cows, sheep, things like that. Will graze. They will, remember, graze means to eat the natural grass. Farmers often take their animals out to graze because that's what they feed on mostly. All right, so let's take a look at some of the animals, the most common animals that fall in this group. So common examples include elephants, again very large. They're mammals. Hippos. Cattle, again, like I said, any animals in the cow families, you know, bison also is included there. You know, again, buffaloes, bulls, any animal that falls into that category. Deer, yeah, especially large deer. Or, animals that are in the deer family, like, moose, elk, caribou, things like that would probably fall into the herd category. Horses, yeah, especially what we say are animals in the equine family, yeah, E-Q-U-I-N-E, equine, that's like the horse family, so, you know, that it could include, like, zebras and, you know, all different styles of horses and stuff like that. So, camels, again, you know, large, whales, definitely large, also mammals, you know, so most of these fall into that sort of category, so. Herd is probably one of the most common ones we use for groups of animals. All right, here's the next point to pay attention to. It is important to note that some animals could also be referred to by several name groups. So if you hear that, you know, one is herd and you say, I've heard a different name for that animal. Well, that's possible. A lot. There are a number of animals that may be referred to in two and three groups. I give you one example here. Hippos. Hippos has, what about five, I think. A group of hippos could be called a herd, could be called a crash, could be called a dale, could be called a blout, or could be called a pod. So that's really a lot. Even though, to be honest with you, I think I hear herd the most. But, okay. So, or we say a group of camels could be called a herd, could be called a caravan. It could also be called a flock. I was kind of surprised with that because we're going to get to flock later. Usually there's the three different animals cover most of that group. That's all herd so far. All right, if we talk about pack, all right, what kind of group is a pack? A group of animals that live and hunt together. See, a herd does not necessarily hunt together. They live together, and they may eat or drink together, but they don't really hunt. So packs usually hunt, especially animals in the canine family, so the dog family. Yes, so all right, here are some common examples. Are a pack of wolves, a pack of hounds. Yeah, we can say a pack of stray dogs, like in Australia, a pack of dingoes, a pack of coyotes, any animals that fall into the dog family, we definitely use pack for. So it covers all of them. This is one that's a little weird. We say a pack of rats. We often hear a pack of rats. Not quite sure they really hunt together, but we use pack for them. This is one that's a little strange. I think maybe if you study dinosaurs more, they talk about carnivorous dinosaurs. They used to use that. So if you went, even though who really knows what which dinosaurs really lived in packs, but they actually have that on the list of packs. So carnivorous, so meat eating dinosaurs, etc. Okay, and all right, let's take a look at the next one that's pretty big. A flock. A group of birds. Yeah, probably most birds. Not necessarily 100%, no. But most birds probably could be referred to as a flock. We also use it with sheep and goats. Just like I said, you know, sheep was also herd too. So these are common ones that we hear with flock. We often hear flock. So again, I gave you the examples of a flock of seagulls. I don't remember, I think they used to be a band in the 1980s, it was called a flock of seagulls, a flock of pigeons, etc. And remember, I said, even though it seems strange, that they also said a flock of camels. It doesn't quite fit into this category. But again, it's surprising that sometimes they may use the animal name for a particular group. But I think birds, sheep, and goats covers most of the flock that you'll hear. Again, there's so many names. You probably don't really need to learn them all because we don't talk about them all very much. Again, I chose these four because these are the four that you hear most commonly in articles or news reports or, you know, that's talking about animals. Okay, and the last one is school. A large number of fish or other sea creatures moving through the water together. Yeah, we use it with a lot of different fish. You know, especially when you see all the fish, they're all swimming in the same direction, swimming together. We use it for that. So we say school of dolphins, school of tuna, snapper fish, minnows. Minnows, I think minnows were the one that was in Finding Nemo movie. But anyway, so this covers them all. Again, there are many, many more animal groups. And like I said, it's probably really not necessary to learn them all. These four are the main ones that you'll probably hear most often, so that's why I covered them in this lesson. Okay, thank you for your time. Bye-bye.